Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to today's video. Now today it's another product review for you and this time it's a RGB video light with a difference. This one has the facilities to be controlled by Bluetooth from your smartphone. So if you have this in a remote location, you can control its mode, brightness, hue, saturation, whatever parameter from the app. And I'll be showing you that later in the video. Well, first of all, it was sent to me by Pergear for review, and I'll put links to their site in the video description below. If you're in the market for any photographic accessories, their site is the one to have a look at first. Some great bargains available on their website. Now, this light was kindly sent to me by Pergear for review. There's no script attached. What I say in this video is my own words, my own thoughts and feelings about this light. So you can be rest assured that if there are problems with the light, then you will hear about them in this particular video. So it's an RGB video light with Bluetooth control technology. So let's have a look at the light itself. And in the box, so this is the actual light itself. Calls itself the Laofas Rainbow Sophomore. It measures 120 by 68 by 26, so it's very small. It's got a metal frame but plastic rear, and obviously the plastic front to allow the light to come through. I guess the plastic has allowed the Bluetooth technology to penetrate into the device to control it. I have reviewed the Laofas LED lights before, and this one is the Rainbow Fresh. So it's the same size effectively as this one, but this one doesn't have Bluetooth technology, so it's all metal, much more sturdier. So that was a previous model I reviewed. This is the latest model they have sent me to review for you. So it's much lighter by the fact that it's not all metal construction, but having said that, it's still sturdy. We've got a 1/4-20 mount on the side and bottom, so you can actually mount this to a tripod. It has magnets, so if you've got a magnetic surface you can clip this to, then it will hold in place. Obviously it needs to be a flat surface. Here on the stand here it's just about holding, but it does tend to slide down, but on a flat surface the magnets are sufficient strength to hold it in place. Now the light itself consists of 28 LEDs plus 24 RGB LEDs, so you can actually change the colour temperature by mixing the light sources in there. You do get provided with this silicone rubber diffuser screen, so if you wanted to diffuse it even more, you can clip this over the front of that and the light will be softened down a little bit more. Let's have a look around the device itself. So on the top we've got a small OLED display which tells you the condition of things like Bluetooth connectivity, the channel you're in, the status of the Bluetooth device. If you're not controlling it from Bluetooth, then you've got all the controls available on the top. To change the mode, use the set button. So we can go from the HSI mode to the RGB white mode to the scene modes. And there's a variety of scenes that you can actually scroll through there if you wanted to use this for special effects in your videos, for example. In the color temperature mode, you can change the color temperature from 2500, which is obviously the warm end of the spectrum, to 8500, which is at the cold end of the spectrum. And you can change those in increments of 100 degree Kelvin. So you can actually change this to whatever color temperature you want to set. The next mode is Hue Saturation Intensity, HSI. At the moment we're in Hue 0, which is the red portion of the spectrum. Using the function button, we can actually scroll through in steps of 1 degree, so we can actually change the hue colour. Now, unfortunately, with this light and with the previous model, you're not given a chart to tell you which angle to set to give you the hue that you require. So we know that Hue 0 or 360 is red. Then if you cycle through to 120, you get green. Then if you go through to 240, and you can go through in steps of 1 degree, at 240, you're into blue. So back to the hue position of 0 or 360, we're in red. You can use the function button then to change the saturation. If you click it in, you get the saturation, and then you can use the dim to change the power level. So that is the eye part. So we've got the hue, the saturation and the intensity. On the OLED display itself, we were given an indication of remaining battery content. Unlike the previous light, which had the superb measurement, which gave you the amount of runtime available for any of the modes. So if you'd selected a mode and it showed you you've got 4 hours worth of battery life, if you changed to another mode, it could actually tell you, say it's 5 hours. Or if you were using a more intense mode, it would show you you maybe have 1 hour. At the moment with this particular light, there's no indication as to how long that battery will last. I've not been using it that long that I have got a feel for how long the light will last under various lighting conditions, but you are given the bar graph there to give you some indication as to the remaining charge, but no indication as to how long that particular mode will last. The next mode is the RGBW, which is the red, green, blue, white, and you can independently control each of the color. So here we're adjusting the red component of the light, so we can change the red. Push the button in, you can control the green. So again, you can control the amount of green that's been mixed in with the light. Press the button again, you get blue. Press the button in again, you've got the Y or intensity. And then push the button in again, you've got the white LED component. Function button again, you've got the scene modes. And again, whether you've got an opportunity to use these, I haven't found an actual use for these yet, but each of the scene modes, you can change the speed from normal to slow to fast. You can obviously vary the intensity of the effects as well. So maybe it's something there you could use in one of your productions if you wanted some background lighting, maybe the ambulance and fire tender sort of light in the background, or flickering candle or flickering television. You might be able to use those. Now the final feature of this light is the fact you can control it over Bluetooth. 18 channels and 6 groups, so you can actually set it to any one of those values. So if you're working with multiple lights, you can have multiple channels. So for example, here I've got the light set up on channel 1, so I'll select channel 1 on the app and working in group A. So under that group, I can control color temperature, I can control hue, saturation, intensity, and I can have one of the scene modes selected. So 3 presets you can have set under that group. So for example, if I wanted to have a 5200 Kelvin setting on my channel, then under color temperature, I can set the power and the color temperature, and that will be remembered. If I wanted to have, say, a blue hue under that channel, then again I can set that to the hue value that I require and the saturation by changing the position towards the center of the scale, and I can change its brightness by using the power level, and that will be remembered. And again in the scene mode, if I wanted the fairy tale mode, which is this cycling color, I can actually change the speed and I can change the brightness of it. So that will be remembered under that particular scene mode. So if I go back to the color temperature, it will go back to that 5000 setting that I made. If I go back to the HSI, it'll go back to the blue setting that I had. If I go to the scene mode, it'll again go back to the fairy tale mode. So you've got 3 options there for each of the color temperature, hue, saturation, intensity, and your scene mode. So 3 useful options there if you want to have scene modes. Again, you can pre-select colors such as cyan, green, yellow. You can have the alarm mode. Any of these modes you can preset into the scene mode and control it over Bluetooth. And the beauty of it is you can control the power. So if you've got this set up remotely, you can actually change the power level to suit your particular application. Now the light itself has its own inbuilt lithium-ion battery, 3.7 volts and 3000 milliamp hours. It's charged over USB and it's USB-A to USB-C. It's not power delivery, but you can use it over your USB-A socket of a computer or a power bank to charge the light. So useful feature there. So that's the Laofas Rainbow Sophomore light. Very useful addition to my lighting kit, and very grateful to Pergear for sending this out for review. So that's it for the review. Thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all in the next video. Goodbye for now.